An independent review by the Pentagon has concluded that a U.S. drone strike in Kabul that killed an Afghan family was not caused by misconduct or negligence and does not warrant disciplinary action. According to the Associated Press, the review found that while officials reached the wrong conclusion, clearly, it was not unreasonable based on the information they had.
The review was conducted by Air Force Lieutenant General Sami Said, who said that better communication may have raised more doubt about the bombing, but in the end may not have prevented it. The operation was conducted back in August following a suicide bombing attack at the Kabul airport. Zemirai Ahmadi, an employee of an American humanitarian organization, and 9 family members were killed. 7 of them were children. So they're saying this couldn't have been prevented, even with more information, that maybe they would have hesitated.
It could have been prevented. They could have just not done it. Right. They're saying it was appropriate given the information they had, which is just impossible for me to believe that was the case.
And what's so useful about this, though, is that it is a very effective indictment of the entire program. And I think, in fact, there's truth to it. The program itself is the problem. The idea that you're going to bomb someone from the sky based on a grainy image and some faulty intelligence is the basis of the program. Therefore, the program, by design, is going to kill lots of innocent people, many of them children, as it has done throughout the years. That's the program. They claim that that program is legal. Therefore, killing innocent people, you know, through that program is also legal.
And so, they're admitting that.
Yeah.
And they're admitting it.
That's exactly what this says.
Yeah, they're saying, look, you know, we're going to kill innocent people. So it's going to happen.
Deal with it.
Right. And if we had more information, we still would have killed innocent people.
Right.
I mean, this is insane. It should be without a shadow of a doubt. That person is the target. Not, oh, well, maybe, I don't know. Oh, that might have cast a little bit more doubt. We still would have done it. What are they doing? What are they doing?
Right.
I mean, nine people, 7 children were killed, and they're saying we would have done this anyway.
You might think that someone would be held accountable for killing this many people wrongly, even if they really thought it was, they had made the right call. I mean, this is with qualified immunity for law enforcement, et cetera. The people who we trust in the government, who we give the power to take life, there should be a higher standard. Like if you, Ryan, accidentally killed 7 children, you would be held accountable, even if you're like, no, I really thought I was killing some bad guy.
They would make me ambassador to Japan.
Right.
Oh, gosh.
But the people in authority have more protection when they do something wrong than the average citizen. And it should be exactly the reverse. They should have more accountability when they get it wrong because they're being trusted with this awesome power. They're being trained. They're being informed. And
if they would have decided differently in this case, they would have set a precedent that pretty much everyone involved with this program was guilty of murder. That's true.
Yeah.
It's a fact.
Good. Set that precedent.
But that's why they didn't do it, because the program itself is the criminal activity. And they can't acknowledge that, because if this strike, is misconduct and neglect that is, punishable, then so are the strikes that have killed thousands of people. Now, I believe that to be true. They clearly do not.
Right.
They want to just move on with this. And they have the gall to want to continue this program. We are operating a program that, when operated properly, kills innocent people. And that's not misconduct or neglect. That's just how the program operates. And yes, we're going to continue operating that program.
I want to put much more fear into these people that if you kill someone, an innocent person, you could be prosecuted, you could be in some trouble, so that they're less likely to pull the trigger.
Yeah.
I think that would be beneficial, even if we don't scrap the program, which I also support. But
right, with all of the military money we spend and all of the advancements we have and all of the technology, you'd think that we would be at a point where we wouldn't need to go in guns a-blazing and kill a bunch of innocent people. That doesn't work in any other law enforcement branch in this country. The police officers can't get away with that. The FBI can't get away with that. Could you imagine if the FBI stormed the building now and shot us all dead? And they said, well, that's because we were just looking. We got the one guy that we were looking for. Sorry about all the collateral damage of the rest of you. That doesn't fly in any other environment. So why is it okay in the military? They say, well, it's because war is brutal. War is bloody. War is war, right? But now that we've advanced and we've moved on to these over the horizon attacks, where they say we could do these targeted drone strike attacks using all of this sophisticated intelligence and technology that we have, this is no longer acceptable. And we as the American people need to rise up and say, listen, we're not accepting it in the police departments. We're not accepting it with the FBI. We're not going to accept it with you.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, it's... Well, but sometimes our law, maybe not FBI, our law, some of our law enforcement agents, not to this level, but right, they do their wrongful shootings, et cetera, and they do get away with it sometimes because they have a high degree of protection, not this level of protection. But I think that's wrong too. I think our public, our law enforcement, our soldiers, the people that work for us to keep us safe. But they work. They should be accountable when they make mistakes. And there's way too much leniency given right now.
Yeah.
Right. Because
especially
then they
with
might
the amount
redesign
of money
the system.
We're spending.
Right. If you yeah. some accountability.
Yeah. Tomorrow on Rising, David Sirota joins us to discuss the debate over the salt cap.
And Stephen Semler shares his analysis of congressional spending and where lawmakers' loyalties really lie when it comes to the military-industrial complex.
But don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so you never miss a video. We will see you tomorrow.
See you then.